Alright. So, oh, hi. God, one day you just, you open a door and you get your fucking throat cut.
Who left all that trash out in the killing floor?
Okay, let's go down onto the killing floor first before we go into Rothwild's office. I mean, I'm tempted to just go in there, but I'm sure there's cool stuff I can look at out here. Okay, there's a guy over there. Let's hide back here. Ah, yeah. Hey, boy. Just ditch him in the locker room. I love the way that the oil leaves like trails like that whenever it moves. I think that's super cool. The visual effects on that, because it's such a high contrast to everything else, right? Like, we have all this like dingy shit, and then we have this like glowing white oil. Operating a butcher saw. First, a reminder, all equipment in the Rothwild slaughterhouse is the sole property of Mr. Bundry Rothwild himself, leased to an individual worker on a per-shift basis. A butcher's saw is not to be equipped and used without proper training and authorization. Misuse of the equipment could result in disfigurement or death of yourself or whoever else you stab with it. The saw itself is composed of three systems, power supply, cutting blade, and chip ejector. The reciprocating blade is cast of hardened steel and when properly maintained provides severe sharpness. Crafted to slice flesh, but will cut bones with ease. The mechanism for powering the blade is a harness, supporting custom-sized tanks for whale oil, capable of driving the saw for an entire shift without refueling. Care must be taken not to strike heat or electrify these tanks. The ejector is a new modification, casting out a stream of flat blade fragments. Since the girth of whale often exceeds a butcher's reach, the ejector allows for blasting away unwanted, offal, or breaking down dense bone at a distance. Ew. Those things are gruesome. Sounds like a Doom weapon. Or like Quake, I guess. Alright, some showers and a privy. Anything worth stealing nearby? Ooh, 30 meters, a bone charm. I can detect bone charms at up to 30 meters. Go to sleep.
What's your problem? Wake up!
Shit. Where's that voice coming from?
You hear me?
Oh, behind me. Okay, well, let's move.
Where do you go?
Yeah, getting those sleep darts was a good idea. Go back to sleep. Oh, it's a different guy. Okay. Man, this gotta be bad for you. You can sleep too. And you. Everybody go sleep. Oh, I accidentally hit him in the mask. There we go. Just fine. I'm out of darts now though, so. Just use them all up now. No problem. Okay, where was that? Is that on there? Ew. Ew, it's out in the gloop. Ew, God. Blah. More things that I won't use.
Awesome.
Every man should have to work a little for his kill, don't you think? Yikes. No haggling allowed. No spitting on the floor. If you puke on the premises, you won't be invited back in for a week. Gross. Salted potatoes, mushroom bread, eel stew. Fresh eel, none of that canned. The Duchess's knuckles. Oh, blood, ox, knee joints, sliced thin and fried. 6 coin. Eel stew, gazelle shank. Cooked 4 hours. Ooh, slow roasted gazelle shank. I don't know if I'd eat all this stuff, but damn. Give me some of that gazelle shank. I'd eat that, please, and thank you. Oh god, where am I gonna hide? Closer. See? Ugh, there we go. Gotta hate that. Come here. Shit. The two things that I have a problem with when I grab people, and this is totally just me not being like fully aware of what I'm doing, I guess, is on the one hand, like I'll either try to grab when I'm crouched and it blocks instead, and I think I might just be too far away. The other thing is, yeah, I wait for the prompt, and then the carry, I try to hit F to carry too early because I don't want to drop them. So yeah, that's just me being overly cautious about waiting too long to do it and having them fall. But that's okay, I can just carry on from here. Not a big deal. Do not interact with Anton Sokolov when he's on the premises. Employees working during the strike will be awarded salary 1.5 times per day. Show pride in your work and support your employer and his... Oh, fuck. I hear somebody coming. I thought that was a door into the office. Okay, well, I guess I can't go that way. Let's go this way. Yeah, gotta be more careful about the prompts. Bone charm. 17 meters from here. It's... Oh, hi. Yikes. Okay, I'll wait down and let him walk around. I want all these charms. This is a really, like, intricately laid out map. It's pretty cool. There's, like, so much going on and so many different ways to get at different things. Pretty into it. Just right over that wall. Fuck it. Just Daud mega jumping skills. Oh shit, now I have no idea where I was going. Alright, let's find these bone traps. Oh, the bone charms are random. That's not true in the other ones, right? Like in the original game? Yeah, okay. There we go. Scavenger. Not again, not that one matters. Okay. So 38 meters that way. Oh, it was true in the original game too. Oh, I see. It's not that they're randomly placed in the map. There's just X number of charms in each map, and they're placed randomly based on those locations. Right. Okay, that makes sense. Alright, is this the part where I have to look at a bunch of pictures to figure out what the combination on the lock is?
What a sad song the old behemoth sings. It looks right at me when I sit here to have my nightcap. Yeah, look at me. A fly next to you, but I'm your master, ain't I? Killed 100 of your kind and I'll kill 1,000 more before I'm done. Drain you, then feed you to my butchers. Cries of the whales don't touch that lot. No, sir. They don't have hearts, I think. But by the outsider, I think I still have a small one. Shriveled and blackened as it may be. Yes, sing me a lullaby while I have another drink. Sing.
Oh, gross. Mr. Rothwell, my research on Abigail Ames has turned out nothing. She's no close kin we can leverage. Looks like the plague took her sister and mother. Her father died on a whaling ship of your predecessor about 10 years ago. As far as blackmail goes, she's got no secrets I could uncover. Devout as an overseer, it seems. Not surprising, since she's rejected every blackmail offer to come her way. I don't think she's making a power play. She seems to legitimately have the best interests of the laborers in mind. As I interview the workers, it seems she really has them in thrall. They'll do whatever she says, and their belief in her is absolute. Something happens to her, as in, like an accident or something. I expect they'll riot. I keep searching for an angle on her, but in the meantime, I advise leaving her intact. Might be worth considering some of her reforms. I know that doesn't suit you, but at least it'd buy time and get the workers back in there. The butchers lack the finer skill to keep this place operational. Your servant, G. What up, G? Rothwell, the interrogation chair is set up in the meat locker. Fully powered. I've run some tests on the few problematic laborers. They spill all their secrets very quickly. They seem to die easily after 4 treatments. She's ready for you whenever she needs her. Granville, butcher foreman. Granville is a street in Vancouver. Alright, where's the... I've come to learn that people keep their safe combinations just lying around in the room they're in, so... How does one... I guess maybe I can come back here after I interrogate him. Maybe after he spills his secrets. Yeah, I feel like that might be the thing. Oh, also for folks looking for any door that isn't unbreakable. I think even the doors that don't say unbreakable are still also unbreakable. Factory management in our times. I'll just stop to read these. Oh, grenades and the push attack will break doors. Okay. Seemingly willing to risk any industrial secret he possesses, Bundry Rothwild has granted none other than the infamous Anton Sokolov liberal access to the Rothwild slaughterhouse. Sokolov is, of course, well known on several fronts. As a royal physician, he served the late Empress Jessamine Caldwin. The man, originally Tivian, is a fixture in the art world as well, and his portraits are all the rage among the aristocracy. But Sokolov is of interest to Rothwell because of his work as an inventor and because of his associated role as the head of Academy of Natural Philosophy. No doubt Bundry Rothwell believes that if Sokolov spends enough time in the guts of his factories, the brilliant man will continue making valuable adjustments to the machinery there. Who knows what industrial improvements Rothwell has enjoyed since Sokolov began haunting his slaughterhouse. And since the Rothwell process involves keeping whales alive for sometimes days as a means of extracting more oil from the beasts, Sokolov is keenly interested in visiting so he may perform his obscure vivisection experiments. In very few places would this be possible, so the benefit to both men is obvious. For those who've had the pleasure of touring Rothwell's facilities, a number of lessons can be taken away. The man runs a tight ship, as it were, with the lowliest workers scant ever complaining about their role in the scheme of things. The men and women given the most menial labor issued special cards, key to the mechanical locks granting access to the slaughterhouse. There's no other way in or out. To lose the time card is to lose one's job. Lording their position over the others at the top of the hierarchy are the butchers. These men wield advanced cutting saws.
Fresh meat.
Developed by Rothwild's top mechanists, working out the plans after hearing mere utterances made by Sokolov as he commented sourly on the lesser devices used in previous years. The butchers enjoy a special relationship with Mr. Rothwell, because according to company gossip, many of them were with him in years past when he ran a whaling crew, notorious across the empire. The pressure valves leading directly to the slaughterhouse, the Greaves refinery, are a marvel of engineering, allowing the raw oil to travel in record time straight to plant where it's processed. As a note of interest, or dare say even humor, the local fishermen claim the waters outside Rothwell's slaughterhouse produce the largest and tastiest hagfish. This is most likely due to the gut sewer leading from beneath the whales inside and delivering their organs and offal to the dark waters of the Renhaven outside the slaughterhouse. Ew. Ew, gross, gross, fucking gross.
Don't bother. You're not the first of his bones.
Extra elixir rations. Fleet report for the month of Nets. The Dauntless sailed north 10 days to no result. Word is she restocked in Driscoll to pursue a large pod east of Morley. The Delilah's coming back fully loaded. No reports of lights, of singing. Another sign the Barristers lost it. The Huntress is in dry dock after a nighttime ramming off Pandisia. Engineers looked at the damage. They say it wasn't a whale. If it was a very odd-looking one.
No one is coming. I've broken your strike, and my butchers are the finest fighters in Dunwall. Miss Ames, you're about to find out a few things I learned when I was a gaffer.
I'm gonna get you. Nope. It's fine. It's fine, Abigail. Chill. This guy's a douche. Yeah, there we go. Hi.
Well, Daud, what do you want with me?
I'm not here for you. I'm here to learn about a ship called the Delilah.
Did the Lord Regent send you? That old fool, Hiram Burrows.
Hell no.
I know all about the Delilah. All of it. And I can give you exactly what you want.
Please do.
Not so fast. I need something from you in exchange.
That's what I thought. What?
We're both professionals, Mr. Daud. I was hired to get these gutless workers striking, which I did very nicely, and then destroy the slaughterhouse itself. That's where I got caught, and that's where I need your help.
How?
Well.
The whale oil in those tanks out there is enough to destroy this entire place. The important industrial bits, especially. Just open all the valves at once to let the oil start flowing. The pressure will go out of control and boom.
What about the people inside?
Growing a conscience? The factory workers are already out. My boss will hire them on, in better conditions than they'd ever see here. Not the butchers, though. They can die screaming for all I care.
Don't try and con me.
I love Dowd's voice.
Don't get caught. You take care of the slaughterhouse, and I'll tell you everything I know about the Delilah.
You know, I could put you in Rothwild's interrogation chair myself. Why should I bargain with you?
Because it's a long and messy solution. And I'm gambling you're not the kind of man who likes that. Make a deal with me, and I can tell you what you want and pay you for your trouble.
That sounds good
to
me.
Consider it.
Okay, I still want to... 5 injuries have been reported over the span of 1 week, resulting in 2 fatalities. Is that the safe key? That'd be really funny if it was. Bundry Rothwild, the opportunist. Young Rothwild was never convicted for any of the killings. In all cases, the courts ruled that he'd acted in self-defense, the defense of his property. Not that his property was substantial. The Rothwilds were not a family of means. It depended heavily on the charity of the Abbey of the Everyman. The senior Rothwild went down with the whaling ship Huntress when Bundry was only 10 years old. His mother, Ruth, was lost the following year to an industrial accident in the bottle-making factory where she worked. Rothwild became the sole guardian for his younger brother and managed to support them both by hanging around the harbor doing odd jobs for whalers who had known his father and others on the Huntress. By then, Bundry Rothwild was already familiar with the club and the knife and no stranger to odd occurrences. Things went from bad to worse for Rothwild when, on his 13th birthday, his younger sibling was taken by the overseers. Allegedly, the boy failed the successive trials and did not return home. Rothwild lacked the funds to pay an investigator, and no subsequent hint of his brother's fate had ever been learned. This latest tragedy befall Bundry Rothwild instilled in him a view that the world itself was malevolent. Hungry for life, especially innocent life, after a time of black mourning, he approached the whaling ship Cutter and began to learn the trade from the crew. Do we ever, for folks who've been watching Six Towers Gang, did we ever find out the name of Arcee's old ship? I love ship names. Ship names are awesome. Rothwild took to whaling with great success. At sea, he entered the beast with a single-minded purpose and would take extraordinary risk in locating and harpooning his prey. Among the crew, those men he could not beat senselessly outwitted. In short order, he petitioned the maritime barrister, Arnold Timsch, to grant young Rothwild a whaling license, paying the significant fees himself rather than relying on a sponsor for the funds. The rapid ascent of Bundy Rothwild had begun. Wow, Bundy. Okay, I'm going to save because I want to try to take this guy to his electro chair. I like that while carrying him, I can do just about everything I could do before. What's happening? Okay, whatever. Fuck you. Alright, I gotta be more careful, obviously. Thunder, just sit there for a second. Haha, yeah. Bone charm. Yeah, also that one guy just keeps catching me. Okay, where's the zapping chair at? That's all over there. Jesus Christ. Smash his head through the glass. That's fine. Make that same mistake. I shoot them in the face. They've got shields. They have face shields. I have to be better at remembering not to shoot him anywhere except in the bodies. Okay. Let's go. Come on, you shit. Come on. Did I miss? There you go. My arch nemesis is defeated. Okay, so where were we? We're gonna go and put this guy in the chair. It's funny, Daud feels so much more competent than Corvo, you know? Like, I'm not playing him very competently, but you know what I mean.
I'll make sure you get to enjoy this.
Sweet. Okay, fine, magical teleporting GM player character. Fuck off. Let me play the game. Hello, Bundry.
What do you want to know that's worth crossing a man like me?
I want to know about a ship named Delilah. What's behind the name?
Choke on your own spit.
But I electrocute you instead.
Who is Delilah?
Ha! Think I'll give up a friend at the first tickle? That's the kind of thing I'd pay your sister for down at the Golden Cat.
We'll feed you through your own factory. See if we can get oil out of your blubber.
You know your work, I'll give you that. We can talk this out, like businessmen.
No, I'm gonna keep educating you.
What do you care? And it wasn't me. The previous owner named it after some sweetheart as a painting. Piss off!
Who was the previous owner?
Barrister Timps, all right? He told me the story. Delilah was a woman he knew. Grew up working in Dunwall Tower. And got kicked out and became a painter. And funny airs, like proud. She caught his eye, but it was worse than that. He couldn't think of anything else, just her. She whirled into his mind somehow. He built that ship for her and a lot more. Gave her half his fortune. Then he got scared. Came to me afraid. Man like that, afraid.
Where are the drugs?
I needed a business partner, so we made a deal. Then to change the name, wish I'd done it.
Okay.
I hope that was satisfying. Here's the room key.
Yeah, dude, thanks for watching
when
me out.
Ready to go.
Yeah. Sir, maybe I'm gonna go. And not blow the place up.
Bound for the most remote corner of the Empire. Might be worth stuffing him in one, just to tie things off. He doesn't seem the type to forgive.
It's a really good point.
Why go through all the trouble when a blade to the neck would accomplish the same thing?
Because the game is encouraging me not to kill anybody, so let's put him in the crate. Alright. Wicked. So, now we gotta get out of here. But I also... Oh, I also wanna... I have to carry him to the shipping crate. Alright, where is he? There he is. Come here, friend. Yeah, I'm not gonna blow the place up. Because now I've spared everybody. Shipping crate. 37 meters that way.
So...
Well, I don't have the combat darts. I thought I did. Nope. Okay. Is this? Did I not? Oh yeah, no, I saved. Okay, let's take him to the crate.
So, what do those idiots want anyway?
Well, they think they don't get treated fairly. Because they can get fired for refusing to do dangerous work.
What? What
dangerous look at that blade.
Work? We're the ones that do the dirty stuff around here. Maybe we need to be organizing, huh?
Hey, that's not funny. You say that again, even as a joke, and you're whale meat.
Yeah, sure. I'm just saying.
You're always just saying.
Stop listening in on that Abigail Lane's tricky talk. She'll corrupt you.
No. My head's clear. I know which side my bread's buttered on. I'll be glad when we get the order to get rid of her. It's only a matter of time.
Stop yapping. Get out of the room so I can stealth in there. These guys are everywhere.
Mm-hmm. better hear all mine.
Damn it. Wow, this is really hard. It's hard carrying this guy around. I'm gonna lay him down somewhere, maybe. It'd be easier to clear up some of the distance I have to go.
Can't feel my feet. Must be about time to knock off.
Knock off.
Butcher, get over here.
Oh man. I guess I could just try to teleport past him, or maybe there's always another route. So let's maybe try to find a route that's a little less dangerous. No, these guys have come out and surrounded us, so.
Bloody floor. Think this crap with the strike will blow over soon?
Shut your blowhole, get back to work.
Shut your blowhole. God, they're everywhere. Just so much shit going on. These missions are huge. How many missions are there in the DLC? Because they're big. They're really big.
Someone get over here.
Oop. Hi. Woof. Can I get up out of here? Shoot this guy. Shoot him in his face. Okay, now I'm like officially out of darts. So that's okay, I'm pretty close to the shipping crate. That's good. Alright, let's go out up there. Yeah. Hey, come on. Can't I go over that edge? It's really annoying. Oh, because I can't climb because I'm fucking holding this jackass. Oh, that's clever. That's so there's the one thing I can't do. Yes, awesome. Get in the box. Get in the box. I did it. Now, yes, it's non-lethal. Hopefully he won't suffocate, I guess. Okay, we're gonna climb, I guess. Can I stand in this thing? Could I jump like a Borderlands character? Like minor flying ability and then crashing into the earth. Maybe there are air holes. Yeah, I mean, maybe. Sure. We can pretend. Yeah, let's go this way. I guess that's the problem with being able to jump as high as he can. You tend to fall to your death. More often. No, I wanted to jump.
I ain't stupid. I know you're here. Come on out.
Weird platform climbing.
Where do you go? Oh. We could be chums if you come out.
Am I not supposed to, is it not supposed to like pause if I try to blink? I guess if it's I'm moving. Right? Oh yeah, it does freeze in midair, okay. I thought so. Why was it not doing that before? Or I guess maybe I didn't notice it? So this way I can do shit like jump out and then freeze. And then jump back if I fuck it up or turn around in midair. Clever. That's very cool. Right, it's because I've been moving forward while I was jumping. If I'm just not touching any of the keys. Yeah, alright, let's try this. Let's try to get to that thing. Nope. I understand now. I see how it works. I could see I could see how it was working on flat ground, but... Right. You can't, oh, that's funny. You just tap it forward. You have so much more control over blinking now. Ah, man, that's so weird. All right, let's try to sort of jump up there, maybe. Why am I stuck on? There we go. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, okay. Rad. All right, where's that fucking thing? Man, Daud, you are something special. Let's see, I got 3 rooms now. Okay, not quite enough. It's raining men. Hallelujah, it's raining men. Oof. Okay, so now I've got some other stuff that I, there's some other stuff that I need to do, like, for example, Granny's recipe. I need that weeper, and I need to obviously escape the slaughterhouse. So, and I think there might still be shit for me to find. There's one outside, I know for sure. Oh, there was a letter up there? Interesting. Let's go look at it. Let's fall and die. Oh yeah, there sure is. You're safe now. No one can find you here. No one. No one can reach you here. I almost died trying, and I'm a better climber than any of them. But you give me claws for the climb. You want me as much as I want you. We'll stay here till I've forgotten about us. We will stay here for as long as it takes. I feel like sleeping. Don't leave me while I sleep because I need you. I'll stay as long as I can. Forever. What the fuck? Oh, impaled on whale bones. Okay, I don't need to skulk around up here. I can go out the main entrance now. We're back out the sewer, I guess. Let's try the main exit. There might be some other things going on that I can, Alright, back to the yard. Well, now that I know how to do the jump pause thing, that's... I got options for days. My experiments continue with what I've been calling the Arc Mine. Initially, I began the work out of idle curiosity. Waking up for a nap in the middle of the afternoon during the month of clans, I wondered whether it would be possible to separate a flat disc filled with refined whale oil from an array of very short striking rods until the time a sufficient weight could be applied to the upper side of the device. After turning to pragmatic considerations, I imagine the Arc Mine might be used to incinerate some unfortunate member of enemy fortresses approaching, say, a military encampment. I have After early tests on livestock proved successful, I requested a live human subject already scheduled for execution for crimes that were, I assure you, most dire. Burroughs was more than happy to comply, assuming he had witnessed the demonstration. Ew. Brought a prisoner from Coldridge, someone named Vaughn, I believe. I turned him loose in the test area blindfolded, stumbling around until he triggered the device. Burroughs was most pleased, not only because of the Arc Mine's effectiveness as a lethal deterrent, but also because of its potential psychological impact on enemy forces. Further, it left no gore or other mess, and Burroughs is a strong supporter of anything clean and tidy. Lovely and terrifying, with nothing left to wipe up. Those were his exact words. I've left notes to myself, assuming I pick up the project again. Is there maybe a way to produce a version of the Arc Mine that's entirely harmless, rendering the subject unconscious? Much more testing is required. Nice. Knockout mine.
Under plague conditions, failure to report for work at industries deemed vital to state interests has been declared treasonous by the Lord Regent.
So that's the room that I was trying to get to before. Oh, Jesus, that teleporter makes it so much easier. If only I'd known that like 2 hours ago. Okay. We got 4 now. Okay, let's turn on rank 2 of blink. Yeah, super blink. Do I have... Okay, now, so where is there a weeper that I can use? How do I find a weeper? Yeah, no, I knew about the time freezing thing before, at the beginning. Like, I knew that it existed, but I didn't fully internalize how it worked. And now I get it. Now I understand. There's a difference between being told what the Matrix is and seeing it for yourself. It wasn't even about reading. Like, I read and understood the way that it worked. I just didn't process how to actually make it do that in game. Yeah, so because I was doing that, I was still holding forward for momentum's sake, because it does work quite differently from the original. It's fine, man. There's nobody up here. It's cool. Alright.
Where are you?
Let's go. Oh shit, yeah, it's fun too. Okay, so here's Granny's zone. Stay away from the granny zone. Yeah, it's probably gonna be in like an alley. Oh, here we go. It's a plague warning. Uh oh, Billy.
We're not done yet, assassin. What about the shrines? Tell me about the blood rituals.
Oh, my magic.
Probably runs into everything.
Yeah. It was probably rats. It's probably rats that dropped that gas grenade on me. Okay, so there's 3 of them down there.
Going to be bad.
Guarding that body I want.
My shit digger. I know you're here somewhere, scum. Die, you. Alright, I won't be catching this rat bastard.
Huh, rat bastard. I get it. Can I drop in here and knock this guy out? Apparently not. So landing makes enough noise. All right, maybe I need one of those rat smoke bombs again. No, that doesn't. That just makes them fight. Okay, all right. Oh, I want that body. I want your body. Three of them facing away. I love that they're all facing the opposite direction from me. Like, they're facing in a line. You fucking idiots. What a bunch of morons. Wow. Oh, boy. Really just solid work. Solid work, overseers. Boy. Hi, Billy. Excuse me, I just have something I gotta do. How do I just lay him down here? There we go. Whoa. Thanks, Grandma. What did I get? What did you get? What did I get for my birthday? Oh, it was just a rune. Okay. Wow, a bunch of dumbasses. All right, let's get up here. Hey, Billy.
Thank you. Let's go. I'm worried they sent for the hounds.
Sorry, gas mask, m'lady. Let's get out of here. Cool. Damn. Right, let's go, Billy. Let's leave.
Thank you. Let's go. I'm worried they sent for the hounds.
Yeah, those damn roof hounds.
I'm still trying to figure out why you let the Empress's bodyguard go. And now Rothwild's snug in a box. What's got into you?
Snug as a thug in a box.
Up in the legal district. I know it pretty well. From what I hear, the Timsh family is practically at war with itself. Talk to his niece Tali if you can. I should probably tag along when you go. Crazy rich people are buying up a lot of that Sokolov security technology these days. Keeps the weepers and looters out. I might be useful.
Hell yeah, you should. Let's get out of here, though.
Let's go.
Yes. We did it. All right. Yeah, this is the first thing I look at every time. So, unconscious bodies found. Didn't kill anybody. I did a bunch of special shit, but this is what I wanted. 6 runes, 5 bone charms. We good. All right. Let's do legal district after a short break. Yeah? Take 3 minutes. Go over to drink water. Come back. More sneaky sneaky. Okay. Stick around. We will be right back.